Hi friends, this is the second and last video under the heading of defuzzification. Previously we have seen the defuzzification to crisp sets, that means the conversion of fuzzy sets into crisp sets. Now we are dealing defuzzification to crisp value, that means conversion of fuzzy sets into crisp value. It will come to a value, that means some numerical. And let us see. Yeah, these are the defuzzification methods. There are only two types of defuzzification methods. One is defuzzification to crisp sets. Second one is defuzzification to scalars or crisp value. So in defuzzification to crisp value, there are seven more methods. One is max membership principle, centroid method, weighted average method, mean max method, center of sums method, center of largest area, first or last maxima. So these are the different types of methods in defuzzification to scalar or defuzzification to crisp value. Now let us see one by one. First, max membership principle. This is the max membership principle here. So this is also called as height method. And this is limited to peaked output functions. That means if your fuzzy set is having only one maximum value, then that output is called peaked output functions. If your fuzzy set is like that, then you can directly apply max membership principle and you can directly arrive at the value of defuzzified value, that is z star. Yeah, here this is the z star. So whatever may be the maximum value available with that fuzzy set, and that should be only one. If there are many values, then this method is not applicable, and this method is applicable for the peaked output function. That means it should have only one maximum value, then this is called max membership principle. And the principle is given here, mu c of z star is greater than or equal to mu c of z, where z belongs to capital Z. So you have to see where z star is the required defuzzified value, and that should be compared with each and every all values in the set, fuzzy set. Then the z star value should be the maximum compared to all, and that should be equal or more than the all other values, then that will be taken as the defuzzified value. Very simple. But the condition is it should be a peaked output function, then the peak value will give us the defuzzified value. Simple. Max membership principle first. Next, coming to the second one. Second one is centroid method. This principle is also called as center of area or center of gravity. So this centroid method is called center of area method or center of gravity method, and this is the most prevalent physical appealing of all defuzzification methods, because it gives the center of area, it gives the center value of the area, so that you can feel that this is the exact value. And the algebraic expression is like this: integral of mu c of z z dz divided by integral of mu c of z dz. Here mu c of z is the equation of the line. So from one point to other point, you need to find the equation of the line, and then from that point, second point to third point, you need to find the line equation, and third point to fourth point, you need to find the line equation, and then you need to apply the integrations from point 1 to 2 and 2 to 3, 3 to 4, like that. That is the thing in centroid method. Anyhow, we will solve a problem after this video. So the next video will be the problem on defuzzification method. So in that video, we will clearly understand each and everything. Now this is the understanding here. The z star should be exactly at the center of the whole area. That means here, if you can see here, this is left side, the area will be somewhat more compared to the right side. So that's why z star is somewhat moved towards left. Okay, this is the thing. And where integration is the algebraic integration, so definitely we need to take the limits from point 1 to point 2. This is the equation, line equation, and I need to do the integration very simply. Next one is weighted average method. So the weighted average method is most frequently used method, but the problem is this is restricted to symmetrical output membership functions. If the output is unsymmetrical, we can't do anything. This method is not applicable. Okay, this is third method. First method is max membership principle. That is not applicable for the functions which are having more maximum values. Okay, and the second one is centroid, that is applicable for all. And third one is weighted average method, and this is not applicable for unsymmetrical output membership functions. And this is the formula. Instead of integration, you will get sigma here. That sigma is the algebraic sum. Z bar is the centroid of each symmetric membership function. Okay, that is important. We will see all these things while solving the problems. Next. Yeah, this is the continuation for this. This diagram explains how it will be. If A is the mean of maximum of that small fuzzy set, and B is the mean of maximum value of the bigger fuzzy set, if that is the case, and smaller, the maximum value of smaller fuzzy set is 0.5, let us say, and the value of maximum value of bigger fuzzy set is 0.9, then Z star should be calculated like this. Z star is equal to A into 0.5 plus B into 0.9 whole divided by 0.5 plus 0.9. So this is the formula. If according to this formula, we need to apply for other things. Since this method can be limited to symmetrical membership functions, the values of A and B are the means, centroids of their respective shapes. Obviously, we have already discussed. Here, A is the mean or the average of the maximum values. Next method is mean max membership. That means this is also very easy. This is also called as the middle of maxima, and it is closely related to the first method. So except that the locations of the maximum membership can be non-unique. So the maximum membership can be a plateau rather than a single point. So if your maximum value is a single point, just go ahead with maximum membership principle, the first method. If your maximum value is not a single point and it is having some points, then come to this. This is mean max membership function. That means it will take the average of all membership, average of maximum values. So it will give you the result simply. So for example, if A is the maximum value and B is the same maximum value, then the Z star should be the average of A and B. Okay, this is called mean max membership principle. Next, center of sums method. This process involves the algebraic sum of individual output fuzzy sets C1 and C2 instead of their union. Till now, we are dealing with the union of two, one and two membership functions, but here we need to see the individual things. And Z star symbol is the distance from the centroid of the respective membership functions. Yeah, the center of sums method has some advantages because it is the fastest membership function compared to many membership functions of many diversification methods. And this method is not restricted to symmetrical membership functions. That means it can be used for unsymmetric membership functions also. Coming to drawbacks, the intersecting areas are added twice. The intersecting areas are added twice because if we take the union of A and B, for example, let us take in this case only C1 and C2. If we take the union of C1 and C2, if suppose C1 and C2 are intersecting some area, that will be counted once. yes, we are taking union of them. If, for example, if we are not taking union of them, but still they are intersecting, then I need to take C1 separately and C2 separately. So what happened? The intersection portion is counted twice. That is the drawback of this system. And the method also involves finding the centroids of individual membership functions. Again, we need to do the centroid method. Okay, that is the difficulty in center of sums. Yeah, this is the thing. If this is C1 and if this is C2, then it will be shown like this. We need to find the center of sums method, what I have marked with blue color. So this method is similar to weighted average method. Okay, except that in the center of sums method, the weights are the areas of the respective membership functions, whereas in the weighted average method is the weights are the individual membership functions. Okay, here the weights are respective membership functions, but there the weights are individual membership functions. And the next one is center of largest area. If the output fuzzy sets has at least two convex subregions, then the center of gravity, that means Z star, is calculated using centroid method only of the convex fuzzy subregion with the largest area is used to obtain the defuzzified value Z star of the output. This is shown in the figure. Okay, this is the figure. What he says means, suppose, see, this is the green colored one is the green colored one is the maximum area, largest area in this thing, and this is non-convex. This is non-convex thing because the green thing is the convex area and the red thing is again convex area, and by combining these two, this whole system is the non-convex region. Now what we have to do, we need to take the convex subregions, we need to divide entire thing into convex subregions and then find out the largest area of them, and we need to find the Z star for only that portion. And if suppose after combining these two, then it will also become a convex area, then this whole thing can be done as a centroid method only, simply centroid method. Okay, that's the thing. For example, see, let me show you. Let's start. The equation also, formula is also exactly same. The idea is the center of largest area. Identify the largest area out of all convex subregions. First, your entire system, suppose it's a combination of 2, 3 fuzzy sets, then identify the convex subregions and separate them into convex subregions first. Okay, by God's grace, if the whole area is a convex area, then straight away find out the centroid method. That's all, not more than that. If suppose it is not convex area, after combining 2, 3 fuzzy sets, it is not looking as a convex area, then divide the same into convex subregions and identify the largest area of the convex subregions, and please try to find out the centroid method for the largest area only, then it is called center of largest area. Simple. Okay, not more than that. And the formula is also same. Yeah, what he says that where CM is the convex subregion that has the largest area, making up CK. CK means the entire thing, green and red. Combination of green and red is called CK. So out of CK, it will identify only one convex subregion, that is CM. And it is finally doing it for defuzzification value by using centroid method. This condition applies in case when the overall output CK is non-convex. Okay, that means the green combination of green color fuzzy set and red colored fuzzy